Coming to you from Studio 703, a show for students by students. This is BroncoTV.
Hey there, Broncos. Happy fall and welcome back to another episode of BroncoTV. My name is Aiden.
And I'm Mars. Hey, Aiden, how's your fall been so far?
My fall has actually been pretty awesome, especially with all the performances going on.
Yeah, like hip-hop and drama.
Hey, Broncos, it's Hispanic Heritage Month, and our wonderful ASB and Hispanic Heritage Club have started it off with a celebration. A mariachi band took a visit to our campus and gave us an amazing performance.
Our school's drama department put on their annual fall play, performing the complete works of William Shakespeare, Abridged. We were also lucky enough for another performance, this time put on by our Universal Movement team.
We wanted to start the school year with kind of like a bang. Here we have performance with Universal Movement, JV Hip Hop, B-Boys, JV Dance is also going to perform in that.
I'm just really grateful to be able to have met so many like amazing people on the team. They've definitely become like my second family at school.
At the Thursday night football game against Torrey Pines, five former Broncos were honored and inducted into the RBHS Hall of Fame. One was a world championship winner and Rancho Bernardo graduate.
He was selected for the 2023 World Athletics Championship in Budapest in August of 2023, finishing sixth in the world.
Coach Doc, cross-country coach and Coach Jones, the head coach of track and field. Honestly, all the coaches were fantastic.
One of RB's programs is its track and field team, including pole vault coach Tom Martin, another Hall of Fame inductee.
I've done a good enough job with the program for this recognition, but I mean, I never thought it would happen.
And by Coach Martin's side, Coach Robbie Bowers was recognized for his impact on his students' lives.
I think that, you know, maybe I got to help out a little bit. Maybe I made it a little easier to be a part of, you know, each and every one of those, if only just a little bit.
The wonderful coaches wouldn't have been able to accomplish any of this without the help of former athletic office employee Rhonda Ewald.
You know, we are lucky we have fantastic coaches that love RB, have ethics, and their programs are so good. It's because the coaches are so good.
And the late Secret Service agent Stephanie Hancock, graduate of 1997, was also recognized. Overall, the success of the night was one to remember. And now, all we have to do is wait for next year.
Good morning. Good morning.
Good morning, Broncos. This is Mr. Spilios reporting live from Studio 703 with a Good Morning Stable Homecoming Edition takeover. Today's Spirit Day is Pink Out in support of breast cancer awareness. And if you haven't yet gotten your Pink Out t-shirt, you can still buy them from the student store for just $10. Tonight, we'll be having our Pink Out football game at Ramona High School at 7 p.m. and we'll be filling the visitor side with all pink. Can't wait to see you all there. Now, next week starts our Homecoming Spirit Week, and this year's theme is Nightmare on Bronco Street. I can't wait to see everyone's school spirit, so speaking of that, let's take a look at next week's Spirit Days. Now, if that wasn't enough to look forward to, we also have our Homecoming Assembly, Air Bands competition, homecoming football game, and homecoming dance all happening next week on Friday and Saturday, October 13th and 14th. This week, we also got to recognize this year's homecoming court nominees. So let's take a look at our lucky winners.
Okay, is everyone ready?
Okay,
let's go. Yes.
Oh, we have visitors! Can I get your attention, everyone? So, someone in this class has been nominated to be on the homecoming court. So, can I get a drum roll, please? And that person is Emily Silvernail!
Royalty!
everyone. Congratulations to all 12 homecoming court nominees. Now make sure to come on out to the homecoming football game next Friday night to see which two seniors will be taking home the crown. That's your ASB update, and we'll see you next week. Peace out, Stable. Mr. Spileo signing out.
So how are college apps?
They're actually going really well. How are yours?
Mine are going amazing. I've been accepted into every school and even NASA.
You haven't started on that
yet? I haven't started yet. Yeah, no.
The AVID program is a tool for Broncos to feel more prepared for college. It stands for Advancement Via Individual Determination and helps develop a myriad of skills.
AVID is a college and career readiness program that helps students learn the skills that are required to be college and career ready. We work on building student agency, which is the belief that they can achieve their dreams.
All the time that I've been in AVID, I have built a lot of organization skills, team building skills, and just building an overall better relationship with school.
Seniors and juniors are busy getting ready for college, while freshmen and sophomores are fine-tuning their academic skills.
In class, we will have many presentations from different colleges, and we go through like application processes and everything, and all your questions about college can be answered.
When you walk into an AVID classroom, you're going to see the most diversity, you're going to see a family environment, and we're all here to learn about how to get to college.
Kids should join AVID because it's really a good atmosphere to be in. Everyone loves to help, so There's no wrong way to join AVID.
We're all like in the same boat, really, and we can just help each other out whenever we need, and there's always somebody there for you.
Now that I've been in AVID for as long as I have been, I can't see myself not being in AVID for everything I've learned.
Wow, you really have to stop procrastinating.
Yeah, okay, so what about football?
They've had some really intense games this season.
And girls tennis is in the middle of their season.
Field hockey team is determined to win and outplay the competition at every occasion. Girls tennis is dominating their new league, but their success isn't only on the court.
We've been doing really well. We've had a few good wins. We're in a really tough league this year. I really, really do want to win a CIF championship this year, and I think we have a really, really solid chance.
The biggest strength is us as a team. It's like a family. I can honestly say I love coming to practice every day. I think they do as well.
Tennis has turned me into a very mentally strong person. You just have to learn, get back up, keep fighting for the next point.
The football team is crushing the competition, but now it's under some new leadership.
Every week we're trying to win and beat our opponent, but I think ultimately we're not defined by wins and losses.
Our team strengths are definitely our camaraderie and the community we have together. Everyone's just hype, full of energy before practice, before games. Football taught me leadership, especially being a part of Aegis, which is like our captains. Definitely taught me leadership and how to help people that are below you or need help improving on different mechanics or learning the play.
If the boys go on and take some from this year, accountability and fighting through adversity, I think it would be a success. The way they believe in each other, the way we work, the way we compete, it's going to show at the second half of the season.
So what's your favorite game show?
I'd say Jeopardy. What about you?
I'm more of a The Price is Right kind of guy.
I have a game show.
Hello Broncos, my name is Jackie and welcome to Bronco Brains. In this game show, we will be going against team staff members and students. One contestant from each team will have to answer the question. Whoever answers the question first and correctly gets a point. The team with the most points wins. Now to our first question. Where is the to-go-to spot for students after games? Beta.
In and out.
Correct. Point one to the students. On to question two. When did RB go to the state championships for football? Beta.
2015.
Correct. That is the end of round one. On to round two. Question three. What is room E7 called? Miss Rose?
The bread room?
Correct. Point one for teachers. Question four. Name one of Principal Becker's hobbies.
Oh, he's in a band.
More specific, Miss Rose?
Betamax.
No.
That is not a hobby.
Oh, unicycle.
No point.
Guitarist.
Unicycle. Yes, correct. Point goes to Miss Rose to the student.
What?
Because there are 2 points for both students and staff, we have to go to a tiebreaker. Okay, ready? The tiebreaker question is, how many classrooms are there on campus? Closest number wins.
Closest number wins.
9. 8. 7. 6. Beta.
1,000.
Beta.
I went by different.
Teachers have a chance to say
999.
Probate is closer to
Beta, 1,000.
I went by department number.
Thank you all for watching Bronco Brains. Make sure to tune in for next time.
Well, this is all we've got for you, awesome people.
Be sure to like
and subscribe.